Hey everybody, this is EZ with Brothers Forge Gaming. Back on the epic quest of Zelda 2, The Adventures of Link, kind of the part 2, I guess. So, yeah, it's a pretty good game. I already did the first little bit as part of like kind of the mini classic edition just to check it out. And now I'm back for more because it's such an entertaining game. Got typical Twan with me here, so... Looks like, yeah, it's right where I left off, or pretty close, actually. You have to die to save, or whatever, so, I did go get my third, attack power. I think when I left off, I was pretty close, so... But basically, we're gonna head back over to whatever weird town this is.
Cruising.
Yeah, we pretty much beat most of the... Ah, shit, this area. Ooh, yeah, that third attack power is killing him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so we beat the first palace, got the candle, heart container, a magic container. That's a little town, yeah. Okay. That's basically, I guess you can't save at the town, so...
Huh. You, like, have to die to save?
Well, you have to die to save, and then you have to, start... back, apparently where the princess is. I thought you could start somewhere else. You might be able to. I'm a little foggy. Ah, you bitch. Yeah.
Get him!
So see, now with that extra attack power, I'm really knocking on the damage, getting that XP up. Yeah, did you ever play this much? This one's pretty cool. It's a lot different.
You play through the first one, too?
Chuck played through the first one.
Oh, okay. Nice. Hell yeah. That's legit. So that one comes up. Okay, I see.
Yeah, the boomerang effect.
You gotta get the low and behind you high. That's crazy.
Yeah, that one's a pretty tough one.
Yeah. Oh, wow. What?
Yeah, these guys turn into the El Dragona.
Wow.
He usually drops good XP, though. I guess it's only 10. Here's where we had just learned last time we left was this jump spell. So you can jump super high for a duration of a screen.
Okay, it's just for a certain amount of time or something.
Oh, I bet there's... Oh, perfect. Yeah, most of these, Oh, do I have to use the jump spell to get it? Oh, wait, do I have to attack it?
Jump spell.
Have enough? Yeah, there it was. Hopefully I don't need any more jump spell. I am out of magic. So now we're trudging through this new area. Ooh. Fucker. Yeah, it's always nice when you have the shooting ability.
Right?
Oh, a pee bag. See, that's, you want those, that's a, like, 50 experience.
Okay. Yeah, that's huge.
Yeah, that's nice. Ooh, here's the, free Link.
Is it life?
Yeah.
Nice.
This is the extra life, uh-oh.
Coming in hot.
Yeah, so yeah, you just kill it, everything. Exit the screen. Get a lot of XP. Ooh. Ooh. There's a lot of those around here, that's good. Start getting my magic built up. Get it kind of evened out. Daddy. Yeah, so I can even out now, be 333. That's probably pretty good. Oh, wait, it fills up your magic, so that's really good.
That's awesome, yeah. Good deal.
Ooh. The secret cabin in the woods.
Hey, what can you buy here?
This is Bagu. Ah, the river man. Well, that's good. Kind of uncovering some extra things right away. On our quest to the next town, if I could ever get over this bridge. Oh, you damn frogs. That gives me magic back, but I guess I didn't do it. Yeah. Ooh, these seem to always, oh, I got a bridge? Oh, God. It is still a Nintendo game. Uh-oh. Yeah, these Oasis things are usually, something. Oh yeah, the pee bags.
Almost 100. Hell yeah.
Alright, I'm hurting. I really need to get through the town. You'll like this if you don't, this is pretty funny. Let's see who's. I lost my mirror. So that's kind of like, I think the last town there was a chick who lost something, and you have to, that's how you get your ability, is to solve their problem. What's in here? Whoa, what was that? Aha. Get it now, or?
Oh, yeah.
Huh. Cool. So hopefully that's what I needed to do. I still gotta find the funny lady.
By the river?
Swamp. Ooh, a handy glove. That sounds pretty sexy.
Then, nah.
Now there's this chick right here, and she's like, please, let me help you. And then you follow her inside, and you get life back for some reason.
Alright.
We were always thinking prostitution, but I believe this one right here does the magic. Yeah. So you can get the handy J from the old lady, too.
Yeah.
If you need the extra boost.
You need to go all out.
So now, that's nice. We don't have to go anywhere to find Zemir. So we can talk to this chick. And then you can meet these people, which they're the cool people. Yeah.
Look at this guy.
Use this magic to restore your life. Oh, so you get heal. Nice. So I got 3 spells now. Good thing I just juiced up my magic.
Hell yeah.
I seem pretty set up now to go and rock it. Try to find the next palace. Oh no, that's right, the river man.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Guy, the secret letter, note. Link, you're here to kill them all. You know Bagu? Then I can help you. So sweet deal there. Thanks. Thanks, Bagu.
Hells yeah.
Must be how to get back across.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that guy's not a different guy that has to know somebody else. Watertown. Of Syria? Oh, I don't think that's right. Oh, into the cave we go.
Man.
Ah, maze. Hmm. Well. Whoa. Yeah, get out of my way.
So when you have full life, you have your,
the shoot?
Yeah,
that's still, like, the original top-down. Yeah, this is, like, a lot different. I remember playing the first one a lot. And like I was kind of saying, this one I think I played, but I remember it's just, like, it was really hard for, like, a kid-style setting.
For sure.
Especially because sometimes you just have to grind, you know?
Yeah.
Like, level up.
Yeah, I get your guys stronger.
And it's kind of funny because these are all like the sideways or views of like a bunch of the original creatures from the first one.
Wow. Oh boy. He is angry. So is he.
These guys look mean.
Yeah.
I go the wrong way. I have enough for shield, huh? So I gotta fight one of these two. Ah!
Aye!
Should start me in these.
Hey, we had to do a little break in the video. We had some trouble getting through the cave. It's pretty tough, but I just kind of wanted to start here, go over a few things, and ultimately we'll get you through the cave. Back there, that fairy is there every time you have to continue, so if you are having trouble in a certain area, and you have to keep coming back through that way, I mean, that's kind of nice. It's a boost of life at that point in the game. Sadly, I don't know if I show it here, but you do not get the free link. You can only get that one time. So, you know, be sparingly or use it wisely. And don't think, you know, we didn't just get through this. Like I said, I probably wiped twice. It actually helped me out in a way. It got me some extra powers. As you can see, I'm at 4 attack, 5 life now. So it makes it a little easier. Sometimes you just have to grind out that little bit of extra experience or level to ultimately get you know, to where you want to go. So basically we're back on track. We're getting to the town. You know, it saves everything that you did, so that's really nice. You don't have to go talk to the guy in the cabin or anything like that. Find the mirror, you know, relearn magic or anything. You can just kind of go for it. And it doesn't take too long to get back here, so if it is a place giving you trouble, it won't set you back a lot of time. But. So yeah, let's grab that full life and head back into the Death Mountain or whatever it's called. Yeah, once again, the first part of the video covers all that with this is, you know, we're still on the part 2 of Zelda 2 here, and the main goal is by the end of this we're going to get through this series of caves and pick up the hammer and pick up a couple of other items. I believe there's a heart container and a magic container, so this will really set you up for your next progression in the game and open up a lot of stuff for you to do, ultimately. So I hope you enjoy all this. I have a lot of fun playing this game. I look forward to continuously, you know, play it and get through it. We've had to take some breaks here and there, but, you know, it's something I keep coming back to until I finally get it done, so. So there'll be some more parts, definitely. And of course, as I've covered a few times, I am definitely far from a master at this game. Actually, pretty novice. So, you know, I'm not gonna be on any record time, speed run, or anything like that. If you kind of notice, if you are paying attention, basically you just keep going right. This is the correct path through the cave that I know, I guess, or that I had found or learned, and the fastest way to get to the hammer. See, that's where it all went wrong. I think the end of the other video clip, I go up that elevator, and that was kind of where it all went downhill for me. yeah, you just run there on the bottom, and it takes you right where you need to go. Of course, there could be other, you know, objects, heart containers, magic, or something, you know, throughout the other series of caves, so I'm not 100% sure on that. So if you're really familiar, you know all the ins and outs of Zelda 2, you can go ahead and, you know, leave a comment or something if I'm missing something really important, not going through the other way of these series of caves. So I'm kind of hoping that it's just like a maze and I got through it, so. And then I noticed that they keep throwing a lot of these guys at you, and they're pretty tough. I mean, they give you good experience, which is nice, but yeah, they're a real handful. They'll throw two or three of them, and like I said, when I was back at 4 health and 3 attack and trying to really battle it out with these guys, they hit hard. And you want to make sure, yeah, use your magic. Kind of the beginning of the game, I wasn't as in tune with that, you know, using shield and using things like that before every fight, because decreasing that damage taken really, really helps on a long journey like this. Almost there. See, I think they give you a pretty good... good obstacle course here. I think there's two of these guys, and a bunch of slimes and all that mess, but... So yeah, they really take you down. Full magic. So here's the other, big area I missed the first time through. I had gone to the right after I finished finally getting through the caves, the first time I made it all the way through. And I went there and went through a real hard series of jumps and up towards this bridge and stuff, and realized that I never had picked up the hammer or went and got the hammer, so I had to come all the way back, and I ultimately ended up dying trying to get back to the hammer, so... this is the correct way. This is the hammer building, as it were. And I noticed there were some pillars in the beginning of this. I don't know if that symbolizes kind of that there might be an item or something inside, but this is one of the big, big helpful things for your adventure, really. And what I like about this game is once you pick up an item like that, the hammer or the candle, it's like the candle is always equipped. The hammer you can use in the open world screen just with the press of a button. So really, that you get the pee bag out of that, but that's pretty much a just a dead end. Looks like I what I was doing. Yeah, so I overshot that. So you go down the elevator. I want to say it's right this way here. Of course, yeah. See, these guys are even tougher. They're like the other guys, but they throw. Well, I was pretty low on everything. So this will make it. You know, as long as you get to good stopping points, sometimes it's almost better to die because now I have full life, full magic. You know, I don't have to worry as much. You know, it doesn't reset your skill points or your experience points, you know. Oh, okay. Yeah, so be careful with these. These guys, they give you a pretty good, I guess it's a, like a, the hit animation you take is, it really, I get knocked in here like once or twice, or I might have got knocked in there on one of my other runs, but yeah, this is definitely one of those games where something that's an instant death like that, it just really start pissing you off because you are limited on guys and you do have to start back and backtrack, so getting this close to your destination and ultimately not getting the hammer would just be a real letdown to have to do everything you just did, because the hammer opens up the other directions after you can break some of the rocks. So, like I said, it pretty much cuts out this whole series of caves and stuff that you have to do. You just really have to do it this one time. Yeah, it's still just as tough, you know, going back. Kind of just wait those guys out. I learned you can't jump on them or kill them or anything, so. Or maybe you can, like, downwards thrust them when you learn those moves, but we haven't learned those yet. There's supposed to be some kinds of, like swords masters or something that teach you these things, but I haven't ran into them yet, so I'm hoping I haven't missed any of those. But you get to ultimately learn the downward and upward thrust, which is a pretty cool move. I remember my buddies always using that as a kid. So see, right away, here's a nice thing: you can bust this first rock, and it takes you straight to a magic upgrade. So it's nice, giving you 6 bars of magic. As you see there too, I chose to go up to magic 5 level, so now basically I'll be able to cast quite a bit of spells and stuff to help keep me alive. So this is ultimately the last really kind of, it gets challenging. But see, as you see here again, it's another area where you can get knocked in, instant death, all that. So we have got the hammer, that's a good thing. We will go show you some of the things. I actually kind of forgot about that, so I did end up wiping there. But it does send you back here. You do get to keep all of your items. So now I can just head over yonder here and start busting. You can notice all these rocks everywhere, first off, and they all lead to, you know, different little tricks, secrets, you know, heart containers. I think one's like a pee bag. So, you know, it's good. It's definitely good for the adventuring, and I can't wait to bring you guys part 3 and get into the next palace. Nice, so winding down, yeah, we're all set up. We got 6 hearts, we got 6 bars of magic. We're pretty even there with the 4 attack, 5 magic, 5 health. And we'll be ready to rock and roll. So I believe there's one more secret. I think it's just to pee back some experience. So, you know, don't let that go to waste if you're, you know, not continuing your journey or whatever. But, yeah. Hopefully this video helps. It's kind of just a realistic showing on someone who hasn't played it that much. You know, so you can kind of see my... know, joys or my angry moments, learning how to play this game. And ultimately, it should be by the end a guide to get through everything. So, thanks for watching. Hopefully, you like everything we're doing. Of course, this has been Brothers Forge. I'm Easy, and we will catch you next time. See ya in part 3.